market, there's not much market except a self-funded market out there. As far as your current employees, they're very satisfied, I think Tommy can attest to that, as far as the network goes. Through the years that I.
And I'm one of the employees, even though I'm a councilman, you know, I'm an employee.
But as far as.
And I've always said this, I mean, I've got friends and family that have worked in government all their lives, and to me, you could make more money, you know, quote, at the end of the year, you know, your total dollar income would be a little higher if you were working in private industry. But as a general rule, government employees tended to have a little better benefits than someone in the private sector would have, so. And, you know, I would like to see that maintained. Now, I like what David said about being self-insured, but if we wanted to start looking at going to that, that's gonna take a pretty lengthy process to weigh that out, or is it not?
No, let me tell you. Let's go back to where we are with Blue Choice, just briefly, and I won't be long, Jim, give me a moment. What you have is a claims adjudication with your Blue Choice, with their Blue Choice carrier. They adjudicate your complaint in Columbia. And by far, they have done a great job, and like I say, Tony can attest to that, and you folks have had claims, I'm sure. And your employees are very satisfied. We moved your employees through the years. Unfortunately, I've won the bid. I don't charge much, if you can look at the records and see whatever. But anyway, make a long story short, your employees are satisfied. And that being said, the claims part, what Blue Choice would charge you for that is a small element of your bid process or your overall costing of your the processing of the element of your cost of the county.
And you mean your the administration paying the claims and kind of managing it, right?
That's right. The okay. biggest charge comes in is the claims. I mean, you're talking about less than, I'm gonna say around 15% for the, I don't know exactly the real figure, Dave, but 15, less than 20% would be adjudication and the stop loss carriers. Over 80% is the cost of claims that comes in. And I'm just talking roughly. I haven't looked at the figures. I don't know those figures.
Where are our biggest hits coming from?
You know, you have a global family here. You have black collar, you have blue collars. So it's, you know, it's from everywhere.
Do we not see a difference since the implementation of our employee health clinic that would decrease
Absolutely.
Some of these?
They have decreased.
But so you're telling me even with the implementation of an employee health clinic, seeing the nurse practitioner avoiding having to go and pay the $35 or $50 co-payment or whatever to the primary physicians, that is still costing us so much that we've had to increase everything?
Jane, I think the first year or two after we implemented that, they had a rate increase plan, and I think they did away with the rate increase.
Yeah, 0% last year.
County nurse.
But yes.
In the past. I think what he's trying to say is our claims were so exorbitant this year that, you know, they went up and they trimmed it back. Basically, from what I've heard up here today, Glenn, is, you know, they would like to keep a copay for the specialist versus having the deductible, so maybe you can continue to sharpen the pencil in that realm.
I say this right quick, when I sit back down, Dale and David, it's according to how immensely first you are to a stop-loss mechanism. We can go to full risk, you know, with no stop-loss carrier.
Well, the insurance company doesn't do that.
I know, but I'm just saying, you know, that would take out a fair amount of your cost in the plan. Or we can get, you know, this high deductible. We can start out with $100,000 stop loss, $150,000,
$200,000, whatever risk adverse you are, and like I say, Tony and Jim and I can work through these figures and come up with some sort of plan design.
Well, see, I don't buy.
That's what I'd like to see. I mean, it's, you know, I've never seen any numbers that you had made today, but, you know, as.
See, I don't buy that, that we, you know, county, we're not disciplined. We're paying the money anyhow. I mean, we're gonna pay Blue Choice X amount. So there's discipline in that. Every month, we're paying them a bill. And if you're self-insured with some type stop loss, we gotta pay that amount too.
You know, it just really kills me that it all goes back to the same point that as long as you're healthy, you can get insurance. But when you have a problem, you know, we're having to pay for the fact that some poor child was born and had to be in the neonatal intensive care unit to a cost of $1 million. You know, that is, it's sad that that's the way we are today. As long as we have a healthy population, it's okay. They'll insure us until the cows come home.
Because they're just going to take that money.
Because they're going to get the money and they're going to profit. Well,
the same thing is we pay, you know, when I was on my company's policy, you know, when I was 30 years old, I was paid $300 a month for my insurance. And then when I turned 45, it went up. And then when I turned 50, it went up even more. And it was like, you know, now when I'm at an age where I really need some health care,
I'm paying what that age was.
Sky for it. Say again,
I couldn't help but notice you didn't tell me what that age was.
Well, it's 10 years younger than you, however old you are.
Ted,
yes, sir.
Before you say that, I want to clarify something and want to go back and say that if we can do away with the $1,500 deductible and go to a $70 copay, I agree with Jane, we need to do that because that $70 is going to look big and it's going to send them to our nurse and that's going to help us in the long run. But secondly,
yes,
how on earth out of $10 million, 5.2%, do y'all get $1 million? My brain won't calculate that. Our premium is $10.5 million, is that correct? Yeah, somebody said, Glenn, $10.5 million, Tony? Tony, you spoke to
I think it's a little bit less than 10.
Well, then how does 5.2% come out to be $1 million? It's a half million.
450, yeah. 450,000.
Yeah, okay. And so what we need to do is go to Jane's idea and try to figure out how to find $500,000. Are we paying the employee's spouse any of that percentage of that insurance?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We're going to cover that here in just a
few
minutes.
We need to look at backing out of that and going to the plan that Jane's encouraging and charging the tobacco users, and I think we'll make this $500,000 up, and we'll have a plan that you need.
So you want to see some of the numbers then?
Yeah, please.
Well, listen, before we go back, I'm going to ask staff to look at changing the deductible back around to maybe a $70 copay, something along those lines, to see where the numbers settle out. And try to do some more negotiating and talk to Ted a little bit more about it. So,
David, I'll have some figures with Jim and Glenn by Wednesday of next week, some stop loss figures.
And see what it cost us or save us to be self-insured.
Absolutely. Wednesday. I have it from Blue Choice and three of the carriers by next Wednesday.
Chad.
Thank you.
So as proposed here, just to remind you that our budget for the operation of our clinic is about $193 per employee or $280,000 a year. And on the bottom there, you see our current monthly premiums are here. Single spouse, family, children, and our current monthly contribution, and then the employee contribution currently. And then proposed under this plan, and I understand you're going to do some work on it, so I won't spend a whole lot of time on it. county, what the county pays will be here, again, in addition to that number, will be here, and then the employee monthly contribution, you can see, is increasing in every step.
But it's monthly, not bi-weekly.
Right, and I have it broken down per pay period. That's what we're doing per month. Mr. Mintz, these three numbers here are about 30% of those three numbers. So the employee who has to cover their dependents is paying about 30% of the cost. The employee who does not cover dependents is paying about one-sixth of the cost, right, Kelly?
It varies by single spouse, children, and parents.
Okay, so this is not a straight 30% here? Okay.
Well, obviously, as we go forward, we'll have to begin to work out that, I think. Health insurance is 1/8 of our total budget. That we, if you look at the $81 million that we deal with, it's 1/8 of that budget, isn't it, Cole? But
I think it's somewhere between 1/8 and 1/10.
And from my own private business, we for 40 plus years, we supplied our employees with insurance. It got to the point that we couldn't do that any longer. And we never paid anything for the spouse that was disappearing. Employee and anywhere I worked, which goes a long way back because I went in business for myself when I was 23 years old, but anywhere I worked to that point, you know, my insurance was covered. In some cases, I had to pay part of it, but never was my wife or my children's insurance ever any percentage I could pay for. If I wanted that, it came out of my pocket. And I think if we work forward with insurance, it's going to continue to be a nightmare. If we go forward, we're going to have to start backing a percentage of that out.
So then, This breaks it down by we charge it actually over 24 pay periods. So this number is what the current is. This is the increase per pay period, and that's per paycheck total. So it's significant, obviously. Painful to be at this juncture with this, but it's where we are, and I appreciate the input about pursuing some options, but with our plan design, this is where we are.
So now, a family, I mean, I just want to make sure I'm reading these numbers correct. In the lower right-hand corner, as it stands right now, or is this what we're looking going to, that someone with family coverage is going to cost us $221 per paycheck. We get paid every 2 weeks, so that'd be $400-something a month.
Yes, sir.
$442.34 to be exact.
Yes, sir. Any other questions?
Jim, I just want to be clear. After this meeting, we'll have a double chili cheese a plenty at the Beacon. Are you going to charge me more premium for that?
Not only if you smoke it, if you smoke it, you will.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You know, that's a whole other can of worms that we could open up. When you're talking about, you know, the tobacco user, I mean, I'm very proud of the fact that I've lost 25 pounds in the last 3 months, but I'm still overweight. So am I going to start being charged per pound that I'm over my ideal weight? And when do we do this? I mean, when are we going to stop? I mean, if we get started doing something like this, when are we going to stop with it? And, you know, that's something that's a controversy all over the nation right now about that. about what healthy living is and the burden that it is on the employer.